It's interesting now. Going into this weekend of championship games, it seemed like if Utah wins, they're in. But with Oklahoma creeping up there, maybe Baylor creeping up there, it's not a foregone conclusion that if Utah wins, they're going to be in because Oklahoma and Baylor have very strong resumes as well.
Well, Oklahoma, ranked team. Oklahoma has that cachet as well. They're one of those 100% brand names, and we're going to see if that's going to supersede what Utah is able to accomplish if they both went out. And Baylor sitting there, if they are able to exact some revenge, are they going to be in that fourth spot?
The key to this poll was who was going to be number 7. And I'll remind you, just a couple weeks ago, Baylor was sitting at 14. Wisconsin was at 12. Since that time, Baylor has beaten Texas. I'd agree that it was – I'd have you agree that they're an average team and beaten Kansas.
Why would you ask?
Because you said they're terrible.
But they've gone from 14 to 7. Wisconsin beat Minnesota in a championship game in Minneapolis and goes only to 8. So this committee likes the Big 12.
Well, Wisconsin
that means
has
a,
two
Big
losses,
12,
right?
A Big 12 champion has a great chance if Utah falters at all, even in a win. If Utah falters at all, to vault over Utah, which is scary for the Pac-12.
So we're looking at those three teams right there in 5, 6, and 7, you know, with Georgia playing. It's anything short of just an apocalyptic Saturday, it just looks like Utah is going to be in the perfect position to not get in, to be this year's.
If Georgia beats LSU.
This year's TCU.
Right. Georgia beats LSU, we're going to still have the same top four, right?
It's just going to be in slightly different order. But that really what happened when Oregon went down to Arizona State, all bets were off. That opened the door for everybody, including the Big 12, who's sitting, to our point, right there with a chance to get
in. You all think that if Ohio State and or LSU lose, they're still in? Because that would be the 100%. First time a loser on this weekend gets in.
I think Clemson's in.
Do you think all three
with a loss?
Yeah.
No chance.
If that happens, I think we will absolutely be to 8 before you know it.
Oh.
Because I don't think you can lose this weekend and be in and have the country satisfied that we're at the right
place. I like it. Rick's got the tinfoil hat on. Maybe a little conspiracy theory going on here.
You're telling me if LSU was to lose to Georgia, that they get in,
I agree that they're still one of the best four, but we've got a flawed system if you can go into the final weekend of a season and lose and still be considered one of the top four.
We all have to decide, in the college football world, what do these conference championship games stand for?
Yeah, exactly.
So if your conference is so, whether it's Big Ten, SEC, whoever, whatever year, if your conference is so great that it's so hard to get there in the first place, well, then this game is supposed to be some
we
sort of
we know what they stand for. We've had teams, Alabama comes to mind, that didn't win their division, didn't even win their conference championship, and yet they've gotten in. So they don't matter.
Ohio State did as well from the Big Ten.
All right. We'll see what happens this weekend.
A floating criteria.
Yes,
I thought that the committee's work was made easy, actually. Ohio.